You're welcome to the review of the Open Heavens Daily Devotional today, Sunday, May 30, 2021. The topic we have before us is, but for the mercy of God. But for the mercy of God. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we are grateful for life. We are grateful for this privilege and opportunity to be alive. We say, may your name be glorified forever. In Jesus' name, Almighty Father, we thank you for giving us this opportunity to study your word, and we ask that you teach us yourself in Jesus' name. Father Lord, let the Holy Spirit indeed brood upon us, and let the eyes of our understanding be further enlightened today, that our lives will be transformed as we look into your word and the notes of your son, Pastor Enoch Adejare Adeboye. In Jesus' mighty and holy name we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. You're welcome once again. It's the review of the Open Heavens Daily Devotional. And we're looking at the title, But For the Mercy of God. But For the Mercy of God. We'll be taking our Bible reading from Genesis 19, reading verses 15 to 17. Genesis 19 verses 15 to 17. And when the morning arose, then the angels hastened Lot, saying, Arise, take thy wife and thy two daughters, which are here, lest thou be consumed in the iniquity of the city. And while he lingered, the men laid hold upon his hand, and upon the hand of his wife, and upon the hand of his two daughters, the Lord being merciful unto him. And they brought him forth, and set him without the city. And it came to pass, when they had brought them forth abroad, that he said, Escape for thy life, look not behind thee, neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest thou be consumed. We will not be consumed in Jesus' name. Now, a memory verse is taken from the book of the Gospel of Luke, chapter 18, verse 13. The Gospel of Luke, chapter 18, verse 13. And it says, And the publican, standing afar off, would not lift up so much as his eyes unto heaven, but smote upon his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God, be merciful to me. I pray the Almighty Father, the one who is rich in mercies, will be merciful to you, will be merciful to me, in Jesus' name. Amen. Looking into the notes of our Father in the Lord, he says that when a man receives mercy, it would appear as if the fellow is wise, or as if the fellow is a genius. Now, it will appear as if righteousness has been bestowed upon him by divine, as if his righteousness has bestowed upon him divine blessings. But really what has happened is that the mercy of the Lord is what has shown, has brought those blessings. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. Lamentations 3:22. Now what the scripture is saying in essence is, if not for the mercies of the Lord, we all would have been consumed, irrespective of who we might think we are or what title we might have in the church. It is because of the mercy of the Lord that we wake up every day. It is because of the mercy of the Lord we can walk around, we can function, that we can serve him. It is even because of his mercy that we can come unto him. The scripture says that none can come unto the Father except the Father draws him. It is the mercy of the Lord that has made you a born-again Christian. It is the mercy of the Lord that has saved you. It is the mercy of the Lord that permitted the Lord Jesus to die for our sins. Now, what prevents some people from receiving the mercy from the Lord, from receiving mercy from the Lord, is failure to admit their sins, is failure to admit their wrongdoing. It's amazing how some children of God are in the habit of living in a world where the end justifies the means, where they think anything could go. The Lord would not permit just anything to go. The Lord would only deal with us based on how broken we are. Yes, it's the Lord that draws us unto Him, but they will not force us to be broken. It's important that we come unto Him broken, as the prodigal son did, so He can accept us, so His mercy can fully wrought His work upon us. Now look, as we saw in our memory verse, you know, the verse after our memory verse, was taken from Luke 18:13. Luke 18:14, where the Lord Jesus Christ said that, "I tell you, this man," that's a publican, went down to his house justified rather than the other, for everyone that exalted himself shall be abased, and he that humbled himself shall be exalted." So, brethren, it is to our disadvantage if we try to raise ourselves beyond where the Lord has put us. Rather, let us come before Him, yes, boldly, but in a broken manner, to say, "Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me and forgive my trespasses, forgive my sins. Draw me, O Lord, unto you. Adopt me into your family." And when that is done, that is when we truly would experience the fullness of the mercy of the Lord. In Ezekiel 33:14-15 says, "Again, when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, if he turn from his sin and do that which is lawful and right, walk in the statutes of life without committing iniquity, he shall surely live, he shall not die." This is the word of the Lord, saying even when he has said that thou shalt surely die, and then you come unto him and repent of your sins and forsake them. It is the word of the Lord. He says he will take away that his pronouncement that he has said you will die, and then you will live. You see, God is sovereign. Yes, it's his word. He honors his word, but it's his word. He can take his word away. When, if he has made a pronouncement over someone and he says it's for death, he can take it away and say, "Okay, you know what, you've repented, I can forgive you." That we saw that all over the scriptures, even as we read in Genesis 19:15-17, where we saw Lord showing mercy on Lot and his family. Okay, so another important thing for us to note is that it takes humility to acknowledge wrongdoing. Something I've perceived and I've observed really is the unwillingness of people to apologize for sins, for wrongdoing. People would rather just go on, and then they'll be so hot, even for things that are clear that they have done wrong, or when it's brought to their notice. But brethren, do not let us be of this sort. Let us be of the broken sort, who will not be too proud to say, "I'm sorry," even to our juniors, even to our so-called subordinates. You know, because when our day of mercy will come, we should be humble enough to receive it. Pride will not permit us to receive mercy of the Lord. So it's important that we bring forth the day of God's mercy in our life by calling on the Lord to forgive our trespasses. So if by chance you've not asked the Lord to forgive your sins, and you've not repented of it, so you cannot ask the Lord to forgive your sins when you have not repented of these sins and plan to forsake them. So if you want to share this prayer with me, I'll encourage you to do so you could enjoy the mercy of the Lord and say, "Lord Jesus, forgive my trespasses, cleanse my sins with your blood, write my name in the book of life. I repent of them and I forsake them. I promise not to return to them. In Jesus' name I've prayed." Amen. Congratulations if you've said that prayer. And indeed, we will begin to enjoy the full-blown mercies of the Lord, which is what will bring us into the fullness of His glory upon our lives. Thank you for listening. May the Lord indeed shower us with His mercies at all times. In Jesus' name, amen.